Miles. Curtis Folks on trombone. Playing is the best thing in the world, but I hate the traveling stuff. I like seeing different places and stuff, but the whole getting on an airplane and stuff, I can't stand it. So I don't want to complain about it because I'm really thankful that I'm able to go out and play. And when I'm playing, it's incredible, you know, it's like the best feeling in the world, that hour when you're playing. But what you have to do to get to that 1 hour, it's just ridiculous.
Bill Frisell, gitarist en componist, geboren in 1951, groeit op in Denver, Colorado. Geen plek met een bloeiende jazzcultuur. Muziek is voor Frisell dan ook popmuziek. Beatles, Rolling Stones, Jimi Hendrix. Later, in zijn eigen muziek, combineert hij verschillende stijlen. Elementen uit de jazz, blues, country, heavy metal worden aaneengesmeed tot muziek met een volstrekt eigen karakter. Bij de laatste peiling van het toonaangevende jazzblad Downbeat wordt Frisell door de internationale kritiek uitgeroepen tot de beste jazzgitarist.
When I was about 10 years old, I started to play the clarinet. And I was very serious about that. I practiced every day. I played in the school band. I played in a marching band, played in orchestras and chamber groups. And, you know, I played the Mozart clarinet concerto and all this stuff. But my heart really wasn't in it. That's why I knew I just wanted to play the guitar. So. I mean, when I got a guitar, it was because the kid across the street got a guitar. Oh, I want to get one of those too. And,
is that mic up there?
Well, it was this, when I first put my hands on a guitar was, it's very early 60s, so it was the Ventures and the Beach Boys. And then soon after that was, it seemed like when the Beatles came out, it was like everything went crazy. There was, seemed like then suddenly there was just music everywhere. And then a few years after that, there was even a club right in Denver. There would be bands playing in this club. Janis Joplin, Canned Heat, Blue Cheer, the Sons of Champlin, the Electric Flag. I mean, I heard all those, Jimi Hendrix, and they would play there. The Rolling Stones even played in that little club, I remember one. So anyway, that really got me going, or got me excited about music. And then soon after that, I heard Wes Montgomery and then Miles, and I found a really great guitar teacher who, I remember him asking me if I'd ever heard of Charlie Parker, and I said, is he a guitar player? And then he kind of opened that hole.
Hij leert niet alleen de kneepjes van het vak, maar maakt kennis met de voor hem nieuwe wereld van de jazzmuziek. Frisell's ontwikkeling komt in een stroomversnelling. Hij gaat lessen nemen bij de fameuze jazzgitarist Jim Hall en studeert compositie aan het Berklee College of Music. Wordt studiomuzikant en maakt met verschillende bands tournees in Europa. Als hij besluit zich in New York te vestigen, gaat zijn carrière niet meteen van een leien dakje. Langzaam begint zijn naam bekendheid te krijgen. I was doing a lot of playing for weddings and just one little thing after another, like, or playing in a restaurant or just all kinds of gigs just to try to make money and or cleaning floors and everything. But that's the kind of stuff I was doing when I first went to New York. I was playing, I'd play just jam sessions and stuff with people. And every once in a while there'd be some more interesting musical gig would come, like Bob Moses or Mike Gibbs. But mostly it was just sort of doing these funny gigs where I'd have to wear bright colored suits and stuff that I didn't feel comfortable with.
Thanks a lot.
Okay, bye.